All that we say, man. Snubs.
Let's get it on!
Welcome, everyone. We are here at Pete Norman Court in the Larry Call Gymnasium on the campus of Highland Community College here in Freeport, Illinois. And this is your HMC broadcast here. The only place you can watch it streaming live worldwide is right here on HMC. I'm the marvelous one, Marvelous Mark Masters, along with the Sultan of Sound, Jim Yeager. And we are here for your Region 4 semifinal matchup. It is a rematch of last Saturday's game between the Kankakee Cavaliers and your Highland Cougars. Last week's matchup, again won by the Cougars, 88-79, where Ramin Hinton turned in a clinic with 28 points, 9 boards, and 2 assists. Demarius Plunge also had 16 points and 6 boards. D2 with 11 points, 4 boards, and 10 assists. For the freshman from St. Paul, Minnesota, Miloš Kovačević, the Serbian assassin, pitched in 11 and 10. And Gonzo Bastarachia with 11 and 4. So a good matchup from last week. They also played one more time in early November. Cougars falling in that one, 86-69. So this is a rubber matchup of that one. Big Smooth, Johnny Melvin with 13 points. And then 4 Cougar players, Marquand Adams, D2, Ramin Hinton, and Rashawn McMiller, all with 9 points. So the Cougars spread the ball around quite a bit, offensively scoring. Hopefully we'll see a lot of that tonight. Now relying on one man here or there. Cougars lit up Chicago daily. I don't remember the specific score. They only led by 2, though, at the break, 37-35. Wound up winning, I believe it was like 92-70-something or other. But nonetheless, I think it was 71. I think it was 21 points. Nonetheless, though, the Cougars had a nice game again. Ramin Hinton leading the way for the Cougars with 17 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists. Marquand Adams had 11 points, 4 boards, and 5 assists. Big Smooth Johnny Melvin, 8 points, but 12 rebounds, 3 assists, and 4 blocks for the sophomore. D2 with 11 points and 4 assists. Tyler Johnson getting the start last Thursday, 12 points, 18 boards, 1 assist, and 3 blocks for himself. Demarius Plunge also had a great game, 14 points, 9 boards, and 5 assists. The Cougars pass the ball well here. And hopefully we'll have another good outing tonight. Cougars are 22-9 this season, looking for win number 23. 14-3 at home versus the Cavaliers, who are 5-8 on the road again. One of them 14 wins was against the Cavaliers last Saturday. Cavaliers are 19-12 on the season, and they defeated two-win Truman this past Thursday in the quarterfinals. One half of the finals of the Region 4 is set for Monday night, and it will be Triton. Triton eked out a win over the 4-seed Sauk Valley by 7. And in the 2 games previous hand, chalk was not the talk as Triton trailed by 12 to the Lady Sauk Valley Ball Club, managed to come back and win by, I believe, 5. And they will face your Highland Cougars down by, I believe, 12 late in the ball game. The Cougars came back and scored on 2 Maria Markovic free throws to win the game 79-77. So the Cougar ladies have punched their ticket to Monday night's championship night, and it could be a rematch, or it is a rematch, for the 3rd straight season between the Cougars and the Trojans. The Trojans won it 2 years ago. The Cougars won it last year. We'll see who can become the Region 4 champion for the ladies on Monday night. A chance for the Cougars to duplicate that matchup. Triton, again, has already punched their ticket to Monday night's championship game at 7 o'clock. Cougars are going to try to do that here tonight with another win over Kankakee. We shall see, though, here in about 6 minutes is before tip-off. Now, in the 2 games that the Cougars have played against the Cavaliers, leading the way for most of them is the big man Stroud inside. He had 22 points, 12 boards, and 2 assists in November. This past Saturday, he had 24 points and 11 boards. He averages 15 and 6. He's number 15. He's the guy to keep an eye on. If you don't know the Cavaliers that well, also scoring them for them is Black, number 3. He's a little short guy. He's about my height, but he's got some quickness. He's got some green shoes on tonight. He does a fine job with the Rock, averaging 6 assists along with 11 points and 4 boards. Now, last week he did not start. I have no idea why. He's an incredible athlete. So we'll see if he starts tonight. But those are 2 guys to keep an eye on. Placide, number 10. He averages, 13 and 6. He had 13-7 with a block against the Cougars in November. Only 7 points, 5 boards, and 3 assists this past Saturday. So we'll keep an eye on him. Black scored 14-2 with 8 assists in the first game. He had 15-6-9. This last one, again, no idea why Black doesn't start. I believe he's the sixth man off the bench. But nonetheless, I'd start him if I had him on my team. A good athlete he is. But those are your guys to keep an eye on. Black is number 3. Again, he averages 11-4-6. Placide is number 10. He averages 13-6. And Stroud is number 15. Again, averaging 15-6. He scored over he's had double doubles both times against the Cougars, over 20 points, and at least 11 boards each time. So those are the Cavaliers to keep an eye on for your Cougars, no question. Leading scorer for the team, Ramin Hinton, the freshman from Chicago, averaging 18 points and 8 boards. He had 17-9-6 again against Daly. And last week against the Cavaliers, he had 28-9-2. Ramin is a devastator from beyond the arc. He averages 39% beyond the 3-point range. He likes to let him fly. Expect to see quite a few from him tonight. Also leading the way for the Cougars, Demarius Splunge from Chicago Orr, the sophomore, averages 11.6 boards. He had 14-9 with 5 assists against Daly on Thursday. Splunge had 16-6 last weekend, and I didn't get a good box score of the first game, but so I'm not sure what Splunge had in that one. Nonetheless, though, also Big Smooth, Johnny Melvin, the 6'5 sophomore, he averages 10-5-3. Again, Johnny had 13 in the first meeting. He had a thigh, I believe, injury in the second one. Didn't see a lot of time. Didn't need him. But last Thursday, again, 8 points, 12 boards, 3 assists, and 4 blocks for Big Smooth. He was all over the place against the Daly Bulldogs. Demetrius Johnson averages 8 points, 3 boards, and 4 assists. He's the only one with more than 3 assists. Him and Johnny Melvin average 4 and 3 assists a game. So plenty of players can pass the ball. Those guys usually are the ones that find the open man. Miloš Kovačević, he had a bum ankle as far as last Thursday. He didn't play at all. The Serbian assassin has started for Cyrus Noel in about a 2 or 3 week stretch when Cyrus separated his shoulder against Carl Sandberg early in the first half. He stepped up huge. He was a big miss, although luckily the Cougars didn't need him. I expect to see plenty of minutes out of him today if the ankle is a go. Again, Cyrus Noel from Toronto, Canada, Air Canada. He had his shoulder wrapped for much of those 2 weeks. He got some time towards the end of the season. He played last week. Didn't score a lot, but we got some solid minutes out of him. He played well against Daly with 11 points and 2 boards, and including a thunderous two-handed hammer. So we'll see who gets the start tonight. I haven't got a chance to talk with Coach Norman. He usually gives me a starting lineups, but most likely there's not going to be a lot of change at this time. I expect it to be Splunge, Hinton, Adams, Big Smooth, and we'll see if Miloš or Noel picks up that other spot. And it very well could be Tyler Johnson. Tyler Johnson had himself a game on Thursday. Again, 12 points, 18 rebounds. He was all over the place. 1 assist and 3 blocks for the 6'5 freshman from Romeoville, Illinois. Again, we are about a minute and a half before we get rolling here. And Cyrus, again, he had his shoulder taped up, wrapped up. It is completely gone now. Again, he tested that baby out on the rims on Thursday and threw down a huge hammer. I think his shoulder is A-OK. Again, we'll see if he draws the start tonight. I don't know. We'll find out in about a minute. I doubt we will have a national anthem here, but I could always be wrong. Salt in the Sound, any anthem that we know of? What's up? No anthem?
I don't believe so.
Okay. Doesn't appear that we're going to have an anthem, but we're under a minute to go here. Everything is set. Final game of the semifinals. Championship Monday is almost set. We got one more piece of the puzzle. For the ladies, it's the third times in a row, the Triton Trojans against the Highland Cougars. And once again, trying to pull the same matchup here. Triton for the men have advanced over Sauk Valley, and now the Cougars will try to double that women's matchup as well with a win here. It appears Kovačević will draw the start here. And we will be set to roll here in a second. But once again, Cougars 22-9 on the season, 14-3 at home. This isn't technically a home matchup. This is supposedly a neutral site. But the Cougars got the home field matchup, home field advantage, if you want to call it, and they play very well at home. 19-12 on the road are the, or 19-12 are the Cavaliers. They're 5-8 on the road. Again, they lost the game last Saturday, which was here. The Cougars won big, 88-79. Again, 28 points, 9 boards, 2 assists for Ramin Hinton. Demarius Splunge, 16 points, 6 boards. D2, 11 points, 4 boards, but 10 assists. And Gonzo Bastrachia getting the start tonight, 11 points, 4 boards, along with the Serbian assassin Miloš Kovačević's 11 points, 10 boards. Craig, let's go.
Buckle up, weirdos. This one's going to be a good one.
And now, the starting lineup for your Highland Cougars. At one guard, a 6-foot freshman from Chicago, number 2, Marquan Adams. At another guard, a 6'5 sophomore from Chicago, or number 3, Big Smooth Johnny Melvin. At a third guard, a 6'3 freshman from Bilbao, Spain, number 15, the great Gonzo Bastrachia. At one forward, a 6'9 sophomore from Belgrade, Serbia, number 22, the Serbian assassin Miloš Kovačević. And at the other forward, a 6'6 sophomore from Chicago, or number 24, Demarius Splunge. The Cougars are coached in his third season by Mr. Luke Norman.
Regulators, mount up. We're coming.
And we're set to roll here. The Cougars will be moving right to left on your TV screens. They'll come out in their home white jerseys with orange numbers and letters trimmed in blue. The Cavaliers will come out in their road red jerseys with blue numbers and letters trimmed in white. A date with high-powered Triton and the Region 4 Championship on the line here. The Serbia Assassin looks like he will jump center court. The ankle appears to be okay, so glad to see him back in action. Cougars won this matchup a week ago. Black gets the start for the Cavaliers. Probably a smart move, and we're off and running, and the tip will go to the Cavaliers. That's Black in the green shoes. He'll bring it up. The Cougars appear to be in man-to-man. All the way over now. There's Mason, one of the big men, the Cougars, and he lost a handle. Ball loose now. Big Smooth will get it to Miloš, and Miloš lost it. Black, again with his speed, can get the steal, and he got it there. Cougars now looking to double-team. Driving down to the lane is Anderson. Tough play, no good, but they're going to call a foul. Oh, Bastrachia will pick up the foul. I didn't even think we had a 15 in the doggone place. Anderson to the line for 2 shots here. And he hits the first one. Anderson averaging 8 points, 3 boards a game. Hits both free throws. Full court pressure now by the Cavaliers. They lead by 2. Bastrachia on the left side. Gonzo going to bring it up himself. Just a clear out, easy way defense there. Just a little token pressure all the way over. Marquan Adams, Splunge on the left side. Inside Miloš. Miloš likes to bang. He's going to try and drive on Mason. Kicks it back out. Bastrachia all the way over. Marquan Adams going to take the lane. Fires it all the way over. Gonzo for 3. Looks long, but he got it. Gonzo Bastrachia for 3. And the Cougars are on the board and in the lead. Black over to Anderson looking inside. That's Placide. Now up top, 3 ball partially blocked by Big Smooth. Cougars with the lead and the ball. Splunge will bring it up for Highland. He had the lane, didn't want to take it. Over to Marquan Adams. He'll launch the long 3, no good. Ball saved by Placide, and the Cavaliers will bring it up. It's 3-2 Highland here early in the first half. Winner gets Triton for the Region 4 Championship Monday night at 7 o'clock. Black, nice move, going to try and drive. Tough play, tougher angle, and he got it. Nice play by Black. And the Cavaliers back to a one-point lead. Marquand Adams on the left side. Looking to set the play up. Appears to be man-to-man defense for the Cavaliers. Marquand over to Big Smooth. He can launch the three if he wants to. Shot clock down to 12. Three ball by Splunge. Got it! Demarius Splunge for three, and the Cougars back to the lead. 6-4 Highland, 17:55 left to go, first half. Cougar crowd and bench coming alive with a chance of defense. Black will step back for a three. He can hit that. Around and out. Milos will pull down a big board, his second of the ball game. And here comes Big Smooth and the Cougars. Looking for another one for Splunge. No good this time. Black comes down with the board. Black will hand off. Mason, a wide open lane, and he'll throw down and blow it. Big time miss by Mason. And the crowd liked that. Mason had the step to the rack, and he blows the one-handed dunk. That could have given the Cavaliers a little momentum. Instead, it goes back the other way. Let's see if the Cougars can capitalize. Big Smooth on the left side. Thought we were looking for an alley-oop. No, Splunge wants the ball. He's got a mismatch down there. I believe that's Holmes. He does. He can bang. Kicks it way out top. And they're going to say nobody touched that one. That was a tough pass. Cougars turn it over. 17:02 left to go first half. 6-4 Highland. Again, this is your final semifinal matchup of the day. We played it a week ago with the Cougars winning by 9. Black will kick it back to Mason. Now Holmes on the right side. Up top to Anderson. Placide for three. No good. Big board by Splunge, and here come the Cougars. Cougars lead by 2, 6-4. Marquand going to set it back up. Adams with the shot clock down to 10. Big Smooth now over Buster Achia. He's going to try and drive the lane. He'll step back for a jumper. Could have got the call. Nothing as the ball came up short. 16-16 to go first half. 6-4 Highland. Black has the three if he wants it. He's got a definite mismatch, though, against Splunge. Placide picks up his dribble. It's knocked away almost by Milo. She's going to force him baseline. Good no call as Marquand Adams was in the loop. Jumper with time running out, and it's good by Anderson. Tie ball game at 6. Marquand Adams will bring the ball up for the Cougars. 15:45 left to go in the first half. Again, winner gets the ranked Triton Trojans, who are a Final Four participant in the national tournament last year. This is only the second foul called. Good play there by Marquand Adams. He took it to the baseline, went up, got fouled. Unfortunately didn't make it, but he'll shoot 2. Marquand Adams, 78% from the free throw line. Ramin Hinton set to check in for the Cougars. We'll find out who it is for after this first free throw. Again, Marquand, 78% from the line. He'll set, shoot, and he'll miss it off the front rim. Ramin will check in for Buster Achia. Gonzo sits down, 3 points for him on his first three of the night, and he hit it. 15:36 left to go, first half. We're tied at 6 here. Again, Ramin hitting with a big game last Saturday, 28-9-2. He's coming off the bench tonight. Let's see what Ramin will come up with. Missed them both. Wow, rare two misses for Ramin, or excuse me, for Marquand Adams, and we remain tied at 6. Black doesn't use the screen, but gets it out. I believe that's Anderson now. Placide, Black on the left side. Back up top, Placide going to drive all the way to the rack, and he had an easy dunk, and he got it. Marquand Adams bringing it up. Cavaliers with a two-point lead. No one's led by more than 2 so far here. Marquand will give it, and he'll get it back. He's going to try and drive. Picks up his dribble, gives it to Splunge. Shot clock at 10. Demarius has the lane. Nice dribbling for the big man. Gets it to Milos. Milos will go with the left-handed hook, but he can't come up with it. Tough shot for Milos. He doesn't come up with it. 14:40 left to go, first half. Cavaliers by two. Black has it. One person we haven't called much of is Stroud. Again, he had 20 points both games against the Cougars. Double doubles. Tough pass. Are they going to call that one on Mark Wanna? I believe they will. It is possibly on a hold. 14:26 left to go in the first half. Air Canada, Cyrus Noel checks in along with D2, Demetrius Johnson. Kovacevic and Adams have a seat. Adams picks up the foul, his first. Placide will take the ball out right underneath me here in the universally well-known Jim Yeager balcony. He'll get it to Smith, who just checked in, back up top to Black. Black got around smooth. Terrible shot. Big rebound by Hinton. Hinton can pull down some boards. Cyrus was open. The three, though, by Ramin. Got it! Ramin Hinton with a big three. Puts the Cougars back on top. 9-8 here with 14 minutes to go in the first half. Again, Ramin with 28 points last Saturday against the Cavaliers. Stroud now over to Black. Left open for a three. He looks to drive. Now they're looking for the mismatch. Although, big smooth on Smith, not too bad a one. Down to three, Black's gonna have to let it fly. Might have been partially blocked, but he nails it. Black with a three, that's 5 points now for him, and an 11-9 lead for the Cavaliers. Three ball on the way, big smooth, got it! Johnny Melvin, big smooth for three, and the Cougars back to the lead. Timeout taken by Highland. 13:24 left to go in this first half. The only place you can watch the rest of it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back. The Salt and the Sound having an interesting argument that we'll only know about. The Cougars with a one-point lead here, 12-11 against the Cavaliers. Cougars won by nine in this matchup right in this building a week ago. Inside now to Stroud. Haven't called his name much. He's going to drive. And they're going to call it on the floor. Most likely Noel with the push-off. Cyrus does pick up the foul, his first. 12-11 Highland, 13:06 left to go. Placide will take the ball out underneath us here in the Jim Yeager balcony. Gets it to Stroud. Getting number 15, averages 15 and 6 a game. Said double-doubles of 20 points and 10 boards, at least against the Cougars in both games this season. They haven't gone to him yet. No score for him on the board. Could have been a push-off. Tough play down low and a tip in. Wow, they're going to call a foul on that. Smith with the tip in off the miss. They're going to say he was fouled and he'll go to the line for the and-one free throw. That foul will be on Big Smooth. Johnny Melvin, his first. Tyler Johnson checks in for Demarius Splunge. Again, Tyler Johnson, a big game against Daly. 12 points, 18 boards, and 3 blocks. And one free throw for Smith, no good. D2 with the board. Demetrius Johnson will bring the ball up for the Cougars. He'll hand off to Big Smooth. Tyler Johnson now over Hinton. Hinton likes to step back for three. And his pocket almost picked by Anderson. Nice job by Anderson, unfortunately. Out of bounds for the Cavaliers. Cougars will maintain possession. 12:29 left to go in the half. Shot clock at 12. See if the Cougars have something drawn up here quickly. And hopefully they notice it. Shot clock to 10. D2 going to take it to the hole. Kicks it. Nice pass down to Ramin Hinton. Great assist by D2. Hinton with the layup, and the Cougars back to the lead by one. 14-13 now. 12-14 to go in the half. Black going to drive. A lot of people in there. Stroud left open for three. His first shot of the game, and he makes it count. Back to a two-point lead for the Cavaliers. Tyler Johnson left open. Inside Cyrus, worked on by the short Black, but he kicks it back out. D2 for three, got it! Demetrius Johnson for three, and the Cougars back to the lead by one. Back and forth here so far. Countless lead changes. We'll get a check with that at the end of the half. Pull-up shot, could be a tough shot. Ramin Hinton will come down with the board. Gives it up. Big Smooth will take it up, and he'll get crushed. Now the question is, Big Smooth went and passed it, so will they not call it a shot? I wouldn't think so. He went to pass. We shall see what they say. It doesn't appear that it will be. Cougars will take the ball out on the far end. D2 will take the ball out. Again, still waiting for that Troy Parker alley-oop dunk that was made famous back in 1995. Up to Big Smooth. He'll step back and hand off to D2. 11:26 left to go in this first half. The Cougars with a one-point lead. D2 back. Big Smooth going to pump. And he'll take it back and set it up. Possibly in isolation. No, Big Smooth going to take it. Fires it all the way over to nowhere. 11:10 left to go first half. Cougars still the one-point lead. Splunge will check in. Big Smooth will have a seat. Johnny sits down. 3 points for him so far. Cougars got Hinton, D2, Splunge, Noel, and Tyler Johnson. Just over 11 minutes to go in the half. Smith is now checked in for the Cavaliers. He gets it to the other Smith. Placide left open for three, and he got it. 5 points now for Placide, and a two-point lead for the Cavaliers. Splunge back over, D2. We'll hand off to Hinton. Ramin looking. Now he's going to go for the drive. Got killed, and they're going to call a travel. And they just called a technical. That is a terrible call. The official needs to get a little bit of skin here. That is a terrible call. The man gets knocked to the ground and you don't call anything. Here we go. Man gets hip-checked to the ground and you call a travel and he says what? That's probably two on Ramin already. Placide for the free throw. It looks like it's going to be that type of a game, everyone. Thought we could get away with one, but nope. Going to be another one of them games. Placide hits the second one. Marquand Adams checks in for Hinton as he picks up the technical. That's only one. I keep thinking he gets a foul and then he gets in trouble. Only one on Ramin. Biggest lead of the game for either team now. 4-point lead for the Cavaliers with the ball. Tough shot by Placide, but he's feeling it. 9 points for Placide, and now a 6-point lead for the Cavaliers. Winner gets Triton. The three losses for the Cougars at home have come to Triton, come to Southeastern Iowa. Three ball, no good. And has also come to Indian Hills. All three very good high-powered ball clubs. They did beat Southeastern Iowa here about a month ago. There's possibly your makeup call as they called an offensive foul on Holmes. I don't know what he did, but 9:48 left to go in the half. 6-point lead for the Cavaliers. Black will check back in as that is Holmes' second foul. Cougars managed to foul out Mason and Smith last game. But the game was pretty much well in hand at that point anyways. Tyler Johnson over to Splunge. Up top, D2. Looking for somebody. Demetrius all the way out to Tyler Johnson. Shot clock at 10 for the Cougars. D2 looks like he's going to take it himself. Tough shot, and it's short. And they're going to call out of bounds on Tyler Johnson. 9:18 left to go. Miloš Kovačević will check in for the Cougars. Cavaliers with a six-point lead and the ball. Cougars will switch in this Harlem Globetrotter weave. Black going to go all the way to the hole. Tough shot, but he got it. That's now 7 points for Black. And now an eight-point lead for the Cavaliers. Cougars need a bucket here of some sort. Marquand for three. No good. 8:45 to go in the half. Eight-point lead for the Cavaliers with the ball. Black wanted the lane. He's going to kick it all the way out. Another three ball on the way. No good, and Adams will come up with it. Marquand over to D2. Miloš. Pick and roll, no. Tyler Johnson, shot, no good. Tyler had a big game against the Cavaliers last Saturday, too. I think he only had 8 points, but they are clutch shots from about 15 feet. 8 minutes left to go, first half. 8-point lead for the Cavaliers. Stroud lets one fly, and he hits it again. 2 3-pointers for Stroud. They didn't give a percentage for him beyond the arc, but he's shown he can hit them. 11-point lead now for the Cavaliers. Adams has the lane if he wants it. Kicks it out, and they're going to call a charge. I believe that's two on Marquand. Timeout taken by Highland. 7:32 left to go in the half. And a big lead here for the Cavaliers. They lead by 11, 28-17. The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports streaming live worldwide is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Complaining. They're like 56 ish. Maybe not. Nonetheless, 11 point lead here for the Cavaliers. And Stroud, the main man, he's had 2 threes, but hasn't been leaned on like he used to. Mason for three, and he got it. Cavaliers starting to hit from beyond the arc as they open their biggest lead now. It's 14 points. 31-17. Cougars came out hot from beyond the arc. Ramin Hinton has checked back in for the Cougars. Cougars, a good group of freshmen here. Unfortunately, only about 2 to 3 stay from 1 year to the next. Hinton for three, got it! 8 points now for Ramin, and he cuts the lead down to 11. Highland women with two Maria Markovic free throws have punched their ticket to the championship on Monday night at 5 o'clock. The Highland men trying to do the same. Black with another layup, that's 9 points for him. Another three by Hinton, and that one draws nothing. 6:21 left to go in this first half. Coach Norman not too happy about that shot selection. Black will bring the ball up for the Cavaliers. Cougars have now gone to a 2-3 zone. Bostarichia Adams up top. Hinton, Splunge, and Big Smooth down in the bottom. Stroud now taking some time and drains one. That's 8 points for Stroud. Again, he's averaged about 22-10 against the Cougars in two games this season. 5:50 left to go, first half. Splunge over to Bostarichia. Gonzo will get it to Big Smooth, and they're going to call a block, a very late block. It's going to be on Mason. Tyler Johnson, Milos Kovacevic check in. Ramin Hinton and Bostarichia will have a seat. Again, a solid group of young players here for the Cougars. Hopefully a lot of them will come back, but like I said, it doesn't matter how many you want to come back. Usually only two or three do. Ball up top. There's only two holdovers from last season's team from Coach Norman's second season. Splunge now will kick it out. One of them on the court and Big Smooth, Johnny Melvin. They're going to call another block. That one easily could have been a charge on Splunge. Placide took it, but he's going to get the call. 15-point lead for the Cavaliers here, 35-20 with 5:26 left to go. Cavaliers lighting it up from beyond the arc. Black with one, Placide with one, Stroud with two, and Mason with one. Somebody hit the ground now. We got to clean it up. Black doing a fine job. That's not in his job title. His job title is to dish out assists and score points, not clean up messes. But it appears he's doing a fine job down there nonetheless. Again, 5:26 to go in the half. The Cavaliers with a nice early lead. Cougars will take the ball out on the far court. Big Smooth now on the left side. Up top, Adams. Marquand going to drive. Nice jump. He hung. Could not finish it off, though. And another miss for the Cougars. Black will bring it up. Cavaliers with a 15-point lead. And winner gets Triton. And they're going to call Stroud, I believe, now for whether it's a moving screen or what. First foul on Stroud. Air Canada, Cyrus Noel, and Ramin Hinton check back in with the Cougars. Tyler Johnson and Demarius Splunge will have a seat. 5:03 left to go first half, 35-20 Highland. Milos gives it to Big Smooth. Ramin over, Johnny gonna drive. Got the spin move, fade away, jumper, no good, but Hinton. I don't know if that was a shot. They're going to call it on four. Anderson, his second. And I believe we're one in the bonus here for Ramin Hinton. Ramin shoots 74% from the free throw line. He has a chance to hit two here, and where Cougars are going to need him. First one up and in. Nine points now for Ramin Hinton to go with two rebounds. He sets, shoots, misses it off to the left. Lead cut to 14, 35-21 with 4:40 to go in this first half. Cougars need to find the offensive spark and clamp down on defense. Stroud maybe got away with a push-off, but Mason there at the offensive board and another rebound. By Hinton, Big Smooth on the left, back to Ramin. Kicks it back, makes smooth for three. No good. Smith had a nice pass, but it lost the handle, and the Cougars with the steal. Big smooth all the way up. Marquan Adams sees this crease. He goes for it, and he got fouled. Marquan Adams had a small crease, went for it, got through, and got hammered on the layup attempt. He didn't convert, but he'll go to the line for two. Foul was on Smith, number one, his first foul. And Marquan Adams going back to the line for two more free throws. And Marquan, one of the best, if not the best, free throw shooter for the Cougars. He missed two free throws early. Let's see if he can bounce back with a couple air. 35-21, Cavaliers. First one up and in. 4:05 left to go in the half. Cavaliers looking for their 20th win of the season. The Cougars looking for win number 23. Marquan will set, shoot, and score. Marquan will have a seat as D2 checks in for him. Again, 4:05 to go. Lead down to 12. Black will bring the ball up for the Cavaliers. Goes all the way around, hands off to Stroud, who lays it up and in. Nice play there by Black. He's able to get the penetration to the hoop. And when you do that, people got to help out, and they leave their man open. There's a man open for three, no good, as Hinton missed it. Ball saved by Black off of D2, and the Cavaliers will get the ball back. 3:36 left to go first half, 37-23 Cavaliers. Cavaliers had a big offensive burst of three-pointers here about 5 minutes ago. They extended it to as many as 14. And right now, they lead by as many. Cougars haven't been able to get it too much closer. Black, great job handling the rock, although that one's short. Tipped up Miloš Kovačević with the board. Cougars have not gone inside too often. Now they do, and they're going to call, I believe, number five, Jones, I believe, with a hold. I was just thinking, Miloš had a nice game last Saturday against them. Cougars had not gone back to him. More free throws coming for the Cougars. 3:12 left to go in this first half. Miloš, I don't for some reason have his free throw numbers there, but he hits. No, he doesn't. Thought he had that first one, but it rolled out. Still a 14-point lead for the Cavaliers with just over 3 minutes to go in the half. Black will hand off now to Stroud as he faces up on Big Smooth. Mason back to Black. Looking for somebody inside. They're looking for Stroud. Now they're going to look for Jones, I believe, up top. No. Mason will launch the threes. Hit one. No good that time. Another board for Hinton. That's four for Ramin. Inside, Air Canada, Cyrus Noel. Hands off Miloš, and he'll lay it in. Miloš Kovačević for the bucket, and a timeout taken by Highland. 2:32 left to go in this first half. The Cougars have cut it down to 12. They trail 37-25 to the Kankakee Cavaliers. The only place you can watch their end of this ballgame is right here on HMC. Stick with us. Welcome back again. The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports streaming live worldwide is right here on HMC. You got your men's and women's basketball games. You have your women's softball and your men's baseball as well will be streaming live worldwide. So stay with HMC throughout the spring. You'll see many more games. Right now, Cougars staring down a deficit here and possibly their final game of the season as they face the Cavaliers from Kankakee, trailing by 12 with 2:22. Deuces are wild left to go in this first half. Black, great point guard, now gets it to Stroud. Stroud's been rather quiet, only two threes for him. Again, he averages over 20 points and 10 boards in the two games against the Cougars this year. Placide's been launching them left and right. This time he draws nothing. Big Smooth with the board, and Johnny will bring it up. Just over 2 minutes to go in the ball game, or first half. Big Smooth, tough shot, passes it over to Splunge. Back to Johnny, tried to thread the needle, but will stay with the Cougars as the ball knocked out of bounds by the Cavaliers. 1:55 left to go in this half, 37-25. Cavaliers. D2 will take the ball out on the far side. Again, the Cougars in white, moving right to left for your TV enjoyment here. Ramin Hinton going to drive baseline. He's going to go up strong. Tough shot, and he made it. Ramin Hinton now with 11 points. And the Cougars have cut the lead down to 10. 1:39 to go, first half. D2 working on by Black. A great point guard with great quickness either direction. Look for him to drive and dish. He'll hand to Placide. Oh, now he tried to go the other way. Should be. There's the travel there we could have used. I was going to say, you call that one and the crowd's going to come unglued. Cougars with a steal. Stroud helps Splunge up. Don't ask me why. Big Smooth. Nice pass inside. Ramin Hinton. Big Smooth. Johnny Melvin with a sweet pass. And the Cougars have now cut it down to 8. 1 minute to go in the half. 37-29 Kankakee. Big Smooth moving to the left side. But right there was Ramin Hinton all by his lonesome. And a nice steal now by D2. And a taken back, but finally we get a call. So.
Everybody clap your hands.
Black will pick up the foul, his first. And back for more free throws for the Cougars. Are they in the double bonus yet or not? We will see what the officials say. I haven't seen an indication. It appears it's going to be one in the bonus. Next foul, and the Cougars will be shooting two. D2, first one. He pointed one. And he missed it, but we'll take it. Demetrius Johnson, 73% from the line. Timeout taken by Kankakee with 46 seconds left to go in the half. The Cougars have cut it down to 8. They trail 37-29 to the Cavaliers. This is your semifinal, second semifinal matchup of the Region 4 tournament here. Win or go home. The only place you can watch the rest of it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. We'll be back in a minute. Or less than a minute. Again, 46 seconds left to go. Cougars have trailed by as many as 14, only led by two early on in this game. D2, Demetrius Johnson, the freshman from St. Paul, Minnesota. Again, a key piece that I would love to see back, along with Hinton, Marquand Adams, and others. But like I said, you play too good and you go to better colleges. And sometimes if you don't play enough, you go to better colleges, or at least other colleges where you can get more time. So hopefully we get a good core of the freshmen back. Around and out, D2 missed them both. Cougars have been struggling from the free throw line here. They trail by 8 with 40 seconds left to go. Again, watch Black off the dribble. He's got quickness. He could easily take the, this might be an isolated pick and roll type move by himself here. Going to try to get it down to 14 seconds as the shot clock is now under 10. Nice backdoor cut by Placide. And he scores the bucket and one. 11 points for Placide. And he's going to the line for an and-one free throw. The lead back to 10 with 21 seconds left to go in this first half. Placide will take the ball. One more free throw. He's already hit two so far today. The and-one free throw is up and in. D2 will bring the ball up. Shot clock off. Cougars trail by 11. I would have think a Ramin hitting three ball to end the half is what we're looking at, but we shall see. Oh, wide open was Noel. Big Smooth going to take it to the rack. Hands off to Cyrus. He goes up, gets killed. Wow. Terrible call. They're going to call a jump ball. Cyrus Noel lost an eyeball. Smith will check in for somebody. Going to check in for the other Smith. And guard D2. Probably a wise move. Tries to get it in. No call. Looks good if it goes, but it's too high. And at the end of the first half, your Cougars trailed by as many as 14 in the first. But they trail right now 40-29 at the break. 13 points for Ramin hitting no one else beyond 4 points for the Cougars. They got to find that offensive spark here. Again, they trail by 11. We'll be back in about 15 minutes for the second half. Stick with us, everyone. The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports streaming live worldwide is right here. Stay with us all. Welcome back, everyone. Cougars trailing by 11 here. Ooh. Bumping too many buttons here. Cougars shot 40% in the first half. Cavaliers shot 50%. That's a big issue. That hopefully will change here as we go into the second. Starting off here is Black. He'll hand off to Anderson, looking for Mason. Worked on by Milos. Drops in the middle. Can't come up with it. Milos with the board. Just under 20 minutes to Championship Monday. The Trojans and Cougars for the ladies, and the Trojans and the winner of this game for the men. Milos goes inside. He's doubled. Splunge will pick up the loose ball, and he's fouled. Splunge, a tough shot underneath. And he comes up short, but he did get the foul, so he'll go back to the line. Damari shoots 75%. First free throw up and in. Cougars are 4 from 11 from the free throw line. Not a good job so far. Damari has hit them both. Cougars have got it under 10 now, 40 to 31, 19-19 to go in the ball game. This is the third matchup between these two on the season. Each team won the one at home. Cougars won the home game last Saturday. Black at the lane with the left hand. No good. Big smooth at the board. Johnny will push it up to Splunge. Demarius tries to dribble, crossed over, got caught up, and Black's going the other direction. Up off the glass and in. 11 points now for Black. In the big guy, Stroud, 10 first half points. Very quietly, he hasn't taken that many shots. He's hit all the threes he's taken. Stroud not in the game for whatever reason. Down low to Splunge. Up to Anderson, he'll kick it on out. Three ball, I believe that's Smith or Holmes. Mason there for the offensive board, and he puts it, no. Thought he had it in there. Hinson will come down with it. Cougars down by 11. Inside, Milos. Up, throws one up, tough shot. People getting swatted all over the place. No fouls called. Ball out of bounds. Good job by Ramin Hinton. Unfortunately, couldn't get the ball off one of the Cavaliers. 18:04 to go in the ball game. 42-31, Kankakee. Kankakee fell to the Trojans last season in the Region 4 Championship, trying to get back there again. They need a win here over your Cougars to get there. And the Trojans went to the Final Four in the national tournament last year. Upended in the semifinals. Ball out of bounds will go to the Cougars. Again, most likely the Moberly Greyhounds, who was in this turn in the William Bear tournament back in December, will be the winner of Region 16, who the Region 4 will play, I believe, a week later than Monday. I think a week from Monday will be the playing game between the Region 4 champ and the Region 16 champ. For the past, I don't know, 4 or 5 years, it's been Moberly. Marquand, Air Canada will hand off Ramin. He'll launch the three, got it! Ramin Hinton for three, that's now 16 points for the freshman. And the Cougars have cut it down to 8. Cougars had a big run last weekend on a steal by Hinton. Ramin can take it himself. Nice pass to Cyrus. He'll go up and he got hammered. No call. Under 17 to go. Anderson will kick out. Placide all the way up top. Now Black will step it back and reset. Anderson going to try to go to the hole. Tough prayer, not answered. Splunge pulls down the board. Big Smooth has the lane if he wants it. He's going to step back. Now he's going to go all the way in. Tough play off the glass and in. Big Smooth, Johnny Melvin for the bucket. And a timeout taken by Kankakee. 16:33 left to go in the ballgame. The Cougars have cut it down to six. They trail 42-36 to the Cavaliers. The only place you can watch this Highland Cougar basketball streaming live worldwide is right here on HMC. Don't go anywhere else because there ain't nowhere else. Welcome back. 16:33 to go in the ballgame. The Cougars led by trailed by as many as 14 in the first half, have cut it down to six. They trail 42-36 to the Cavaliers. Again, winner gets Triton Monday night at 7 o'clock. Win or lose, HMC will be broadcasting and streaming that, well, not broadcasting it, but streaming it, even if the Cavaliers win. So if you're a Cavalier fan or a Trojan fan, you can come back to HMC and possibly see the championship game, depending on who wins. Miss there by Stroud. Hinton will pick up his sixth rebound. Cougars have a chance to cut it down in half. And there's Hinton for the lay-in. Nice job by Ramin Hinton. And he's got 18 points here. And we still got a ways to go. The Cougars cut the lead down to four. It's been a while since it's been this close. Again, the Cavaliers had a big run early in the first half to stretch it out to 14 points, and it's kind of hovered around there ever since. Black for a jumper, no good. Cyrus Noel with his first board. Offense has gone stone cold for the Cavaliers. Big Smooth and one. The crowd comes alive as Big Smooth gets the board, or excuse me, gets the bucket and the foul. Basket is good. Big Smooth to the line. A chance to cut the lead to one. Something happened. Got it poked in the eye. Big Smooth makes this one. He could run for mayor. He can't see, I believe. I don't know if he lost a contact. Did? Lost a contact. So Big Smooth shooting blind here. Like I said, he makes this. He can run for mayor. He sets, shoots, and rimmed it out. Cougars now have cut the lead down to two. Cougars on 11-2 run here to start the second half. Anderson, good play, gets it out to Stroud. Stroud, again, hasn't done a lot. And a tough shot, but he nails it. 12 points now for Stroud, a four-point lead for the Cavaliers, just over 15 to go in the ballgame. Splunge on the right side, looking for Cyrus. He'll go all the way in, kicks it on out. Big Smooth going to drive himself. Dish, dish, and good move. Ramin Hinton there for the bucket. 20 points for him now. I believe, was this a timeout for Highland, I believe. Okay. Substitution timeout, I believe, just to get Big Smooth out of there so he can get his contact back in. D2's checked in for him. Cougar lead, or trailing only now by two. Trailed by 14 a lot of the first half. They've got it down to two. Placide, he's been their gunner. No good. Shots are going cold. And Tyler Johnson Mason will pick up the foul. Loose ball foul, I believe, on him. I believe that's only his second. Nobody's really in foul trouble in this game. Again, the Cougars fouled out both big men a week ago. Tyler Johnson's going to take the ball out on the far side. The Cougars down by two, have the ball and a chance for the lead on a three. D2 will corral that ball. He's going to drive. Cyrus was there. Hinton left open. And it's going to hit the stanchion. That'll be out of bounds. 14-20 to go in the ballgame. 44-42. Cougars trailing to the Cavaliers from Kankakee. King Cougars have only lost three games at home this season. They're the Southeastern Iowa Indian Hills of Region 11. And then they lost to their Trojans, who they could see again if they win tonight. All ranked ball clubs. Highest was Indian Hills at sixth in the nation. Stroud, nice move, but too high off the board. Cyrus Noel will pull it down again. The Cougars have a chance for the lead here on a three. Nice pass, but unfortunately swatted away. Placide up top to Smith. Back to Placide. He'll hand off. Now that's Anderson. He's double teamed at least. He'll get it back out. Placide. Shot clock down to 10. He can take it himself. He won't. Back up top to Anderson. Shot clock down to 5. Tough play by Anderson. Stroud left open for 3. No good. D2 will come up with a rebound. Cougars again still down by 2. 13:08 left to go in the ball game. Big Smooth set to check back in at the next dead ball. Tyler Johnson up top to Splunge. Now D2. Not sure what we're looking for. Cyrus looking to bang down low. Nice spin move up off the glass and in. Tie ball game. Cyrus Noel picked the best time to score his first bucket as we're knotted at 44. 12:42 left to go in the ball game. Again, the Cougars have now erased a 14-point deficit from the first half. Smith will get it to Stroud. He's their main gunner. Tough play all the way out to Anderson. Anderson fakes. 15-footer looks long. It is another board by Hinton. 7 rebounds for Ramin Hinton here, and the Cougars with the ball. And we're tied at 44. They can shoot for the lead right here. And an unfortunate 10-second violation. The Cougars not paying attention. And there's an unforced error. Gotta watch the shot clock. It was at 19. Always starts at 30. You gotta get it across the timeline in 10 seconds. The Cougars not focused on that play, and they turn it over. 12:14 left to go in the ball game. The game is tied at 44. Four run the Cougars have here to start this second half. And knotted it up at 44. Black back in for the Cavaliers. His quickness, and he'll lose the ball out of bounds. I believe Cyrus Noel tipped it away. 12:03 left to go in the ball game here. We're still knotted at 44. Holmes will kick it all the way up top to Smith. Shot clock down to 5. This is probably a black possession. No, he gets it to Smith. Launches for 3. Wow, Smith hits it. Only the 5th point for Smith, but a big one for the Cavaliers as they get back on top, this time by 3. Under 12 minutes to go in the ballgame. Tyler Johnson back to Marquand Adams. Big Smooth has the ball, has a mismatch here. Gets it to Cyrus. Cyrus will pump. Going to bang against Stroud. Left-handed hook, no good. Black will bring the ball up for the Cavaliers, now leading by 3. 11:23 to go in the ballgame. Black gonna dribble it, he's got the lane. All the way in the corner, now that's Holmes. Holmes looking to dribble, he'll pull up for a shot. Not even close, big Smooth of the board. Third rebound for Johnny. Cougars pass all the way in the corner. Marquand to tie it, no good. Black will bring the ball up now. Placide on the right side. 10:50 to go. Placide for three. They've gone stone cold beyond the arc as they struggle with a big smooth. Will pick up the board and the ball. He's got the lane. He'll let the three fly. No good. Nobody there for the board. Coach Norman didn't like that shot selection there. And a timeout taken, I believe, by Kankakee. 10:33 left to go in this Region 4 semifinal. The Cougars got it tied, but now trail by three. They are down 47-44. This is your HMC broadcast. The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports streaming live worldwide is right here. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back. Your Cougars trailed by as many as 14 in the first half. Got it down to tied at 44, and then a three ball by, I believe, it was Smith. Has the Cavaliers on top for the moment, 47-44. 10:33 to go in the ball game. Again, the winner gets Triton at 7 o'clock on Monday night. The Region 4 champ will face the Region 16 champ, which could very well be the 27-3 Moberly Greyhounds. Black will take the ball in the backcourt. You can do that, even though he was inbounding from the opposite end. Just still got to get over by 10 seconds. Stroud, tough matchup there with Tyler. Pushing off, still no call. Shot clock to 10. Tough play. Crowd doesn't like it. And they're going to call Johnson for the foul. I believe that's only Tyler's first. Stroud going to go to the line for two. Points for Stroud. He averages 15, although has scored over 20 points both games against the Cougars, along with at least 10 boards. First free throw up and in. Anderson checks back in. Placide has a seat for the Cavaliers. 4-point lead now for Kankakee, 10:14 to go in the ballgame. Stroud shoots 79%, and he hits them both. Adams to bring the ball up. 10-10 left to go in the ballgame. Now a 5-point lead for the Cavaliers. Milosz. Now up top, Tyler Johnson looking inside for a cutting Milosz. Hinson going to drive, kicks it out. Tyler Johnson up top, big smooth. Tough play, no call again. The officials have swallowed their whistle on this end once again as the Cavaliers, with a 5-point lead, lead 49-44. Stroud out of bounds as they lose the handle. Good defense by Milosz. Surprised they didn't call a foul on that. Hinton will take the ball out for Highland, trailing 49-44. 9:29 left to go in the ballgame. Marquand will bring the ball up for the Cougars. Hinson will hand off to Big Smooth. Johnny has the mismatch. Kicks it all the way out. Tyler Johnson for three. Got it! First bucket for Tyler Johnson, and it's a big one. The Cougars have cut the lead down to two. They trail 49-47, just under 9 minutes to go in the ballgame. Haven't led for a long time. There were several lead changes in the first half. 12, if I counted correctly, 12 lead changes in the first half, and that was early. Stroud will take it. Goes up. Tough shot. Milos there with the board. Fifth rebound for Kovacevic. The Cougars have a chance for the lead here. 8:30 to go in the ball game. Marquan Adams will reset the offense. Swinging through his big smooth. Looking inside for Kovacevic. Back to Johnny. Johnny's going to drive. He has the lane. Tough shot. No call. 8:09 left to go in the ball game. Still a two-point lead for the Cavaliers. Black almost lost the ball, got it back. Gets it to Stroud. We're starting to see a lot more Stroud in the game plan here. Tough play, partially blocked, maybe rebound by Hinton. Tyler Johnson, Hinton wants the ball. Not going to get it to him. Under 8 to go in the ball game. Marquand will step back, gets it to Kovacevic. Milos with the hook, got it! And one! Milos Kovacevic, the Serbian assassin, will put the ball in and tie the ball game. And Milos has a chance to give the Cougars the lead, their first lead of the half, and in a long time. Foul on Stroud, his second. And he has a seat for the Cavaliers. The Serbian assassin, Milos Kovacevic, a chance to give the Cougars the lead. Tied at 49. He'll set, shoot, and score! Cougars out in front. Demarius Splunge checks in for Big Smooth. Cougars got Ramin Hinton, Marquand Adams, Demarius Splunge, Tyler Johnson, and Milos Kovacevic in. And the lead, 7:30 to go in the ball game. Again, a date with Triton on Monday night at 7 o'clock. Black appears to be limping, favoring an ankle. Placide for another three, no good. You got to call the slap foul if you're going to call anything. Splunge will come down with it. Just over 7 minutes to go in the ball game. The Cougars with a one-point lead and the ball. Milos, they're kind of doubling, waiting, leaving someone inside to help out. Milos had a good game last Saturday against them. They're keeping an eye on him. 6:47 to go. Marquand with the shot clock at 5. Tyler Johnson, tough pull-up. No good, but there's Hinton for the board, but he missed it. Placide will bring the ball up for the Cavaliers. They trail by one, first time in a long time. And wow, we got the call!
Everybody clap your hands.
The crowd loves it because we don't see that. That was an obvious carry, not a tough one to come up with, but they called it. So with 6:32 left to go in the ball game, the Cougars with the ball and the lead, 50-49. Cougars have surrendered 9 second half points here in the first 14 minutes of this half. The Cougar defense definitely has toughened up, and the offense has come alive, like I said. That one almost went in off the tip from Splunge. 6:10 left to go in the ball game. Cougars still by one. Black with a great dribbling display here. He can get around just about anybody. Marquand going to play him tight. Nice crossover, moving to his left. Tough shot. That looks way off again, and the Cougars will let it go out of bounds. That wasn't blocked. The Cavaliers just can't draw iron here in the second half. Again, only 9 points offensively for the Cavaliers. They led 40-29 at the break. It's now 50-49 Cougars with 5:47 to go in the ball game. Marquand Adams will control for the Cougars, going to try and drive. He'll pull up 15 feet, looks way short. It is, and unfortunately, the Cougars were trying to play off the rim. It went right to a Cavalier. Black now over on the left side, down low now Placide, worked on by Hinton. Possible double by Milos, now he's going to bang with Hinton. Tough play inside, he got the bucket. That's all that matters. Style points don't mean a thing, and the Cavaliers back to the lead by one, 51-50. Tyler Johnson now kicks it back up top, Adams. Possibly now 2-3 zone, Adams for three, no good. Black with the ball. Nice dribbling again. And they're going to call, I believe, a block on Marquand. It is. 5:01 left to go in the ballgame. Cougars trail by one. Stroud back in. Big smooth. Johnny Melvin and D2 will check in for Tyler Johnson and Marquand Adams. As Marquand picks up number three. And Holmes will take the ball out for the Cavaliers. Trying to get it to Mason. He does. Mason will face up and kick it up top to Black. Under 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Again, a date with the Triton Trojans on Monday night at 7 o'clock for the winner. HMC will bring this to you streaming. So stay with us on Monday. Tough play there. Cougars can't get the offensive or the defensive board, and the Cavaliers get it back. Holmes for three. No good. Stroud with a big offensive board, and he scores it and gets the foul. Milos will pick up the foul, only his first. Air Canada, Cyrus Noel will check in for the Cougars. 4:33 left to go in the ballgame. A three-point lead for the Cavaliers with an and-one free throw coming. Stroud has hit the majority of his free throws, I believe. He's got one more. That free throw looks off to the left. No, but Hinton will pick up the board. 10th rebound for Amin Hinton. A double-double for him. 20-10 for the freshman from Chicago. D2 going to try and take it off the dribble. Nice job saving it to Splunge. Demarius going to bang. He's got the layup. Up with the right hand and got it. Demarius Splunge now 7 points for him. And they cut the lead down to one. Just over 4 minutes to go in the ballgame. This is going to come down to the wire. Down inside. Stroud up off the glass and in. He's been the only one that's made the baskets inside. Everyone else has been pretty cold. Back to a three-point lead for the Cavaliers. Look to see more Stroud offense towards the end of this ballgame, I would expect. Same thing for Ramin Hinton. He likes to step back for three. D2 looking to drive. Does try to get it. Gets it right to Ramin. I couldn't finish. Nice pass by D2. Got it to Ramin as he was streaking in. Got fouled on the layup, but couldn't finish. Placide picks up foul number three. And with 3:32 left to go in the ballgame, Ramin Hinton going to the line for two. Again, shoots 74% on the season from the free throw. Ramin with 20 points, 10 boards on the evening. A great game for Ramin. First free throw is off the front end. Again, the Cougars struggling from the free throw line in the first half. Shot only 33%, 3 of 9 in the first half. Two Cougars set to come in now. Adams and Tyler Johnson come in for Splunge and D2. 55-52, 3:32 left to go in the ballgame. Ramin Hinton, one more free throw coming. Winner gets Triton at 7 o'clock on Monday night. Second free throw, Hinton couldn't get either. Black brings the ball up for the Cavaliers. They don't need to rush. They lead by three. Black looking inside for Stroud. He'll go tough to the lane, and again, a tough shot, but he puts it in. More offense for Stroud. And now a five-point lead for the Cavaliers. Adams inside Hinton. Ramin with the hook. Got it! Ramin Hinton with the bucket and the foul, and he'll go to the line for the and-one free throw. Ramin Hinton in 74% from the line, has the and one free throw lined up and ready to go. .256 left to go in the ballgame. 3-point lead for the Cavaliers. 57-54. Ramin Hinton A chance for the and one free throw to cut it down to two. Black picks up the foul, only his second. Again, Ramin hitting for the and one free throw. He's got 22 points and 10 boards, and he missed another one. Knocked out of bounds. That's easily Cougar ball, and it is. So the missed free throw, but the Cougars get the possession. Cougars can shoot for the tie here. Adams and Tyler Johnson have a seat as D2 and Splunge check back in. Air Canada, big smooth. And Ramin hitting in for the Cougars. Splunge will get the ball. Again, just under 3 minutes to go in the ball game. Cougars have only led by one here in the second half. Demarius kicks it out. Big smooth for three. Got it! Big smooth. Johnny Melvin has knotted it up at 57, and a timeout taken by Kankakee. 2:35 to go in the ballgame. We're tied at 57. Want to watch the end of the ballgame? The only place you can watch it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. This is a good one. We're back, 2:35 left to go in the ball game. Again, your second semifinal Region 4 game here for the Cougars. It takes four to get to Hutch. They got to win number two here. They were down by as many as 14 in the first half, have brought it down to zero. It is 57-57. All the Cougars left briefly for one at one point, 51-50. Black will get the ball here. 2:30 to go in the ball game. Cavaliers and Cougars knotted at 57. Black's done a great job penetrating and dishing inside. Stroud's the man to keep an eye on. He has a great first step. Tough play. This one he's going to miss. Ramin Hinton with rebound number 11. The Cougars with the ball and a chance for the lead here with just over 2 minutes to go. Marquand Adams going to set this offense up here, looking for a screen. Nice job up off the glass, and he's fouled. Marquand Adams took it to the hole. Got fouled here, and he's a chance to put the Cougars on top here. Fourth foul on Placide. Marquand Adams, again, 78% from the line. Has a chance for free throw 5 and 6 on the evening. He's shooting two. Marquand from Chicago averages 9-2-2 a game, had 11-4-5, missed the free throw. Against Daly, again, 11 points, 4 boards, 5 assists. Missed the first one. Again, 2:03 to go in the ball game. Chance for Marquand to give the Cougars a lead. Only 3 of 9 in the first half from the free throw line. D2 got the serve. Excuse me, that's Marquand gets the second. And the Cougars are back in the lead, 58-57 here. 2 minutes to go in the ball game. Black worked on by Adams. Going to dribble to the right side, and they're going to call Marquand for a body. Marquand picks up foul number 4. And he'll stay in the game. No substitution for Marquand. 1:52 to go in a ball game. Cougars by one. Placide will give it off to Black. Up top now for Black. He's great off the dribble. Shot clock down to 10. Looking for him or Stroud, I'm guessing. And I'm not even close. Inside Holmes. Mason, shot clock with 4. Black's got to shoot this. Down to 1. Tough shot. Wow. Black with a big 3 for the Cavaliers, and they're back in top by 2, 60-58. Timeout taken by Highland. 1:23 left to go in the ballgame. They now trail by 2, 60-58. Want to watch the end of the ballgame? The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back. 1:23 left to go in the ball game. Cavaliers by 2. They went toe-to-toe with Triton for the Region 4 last season. They're 1:23 away from another rematch. The Cougars want to duplicate the Region 4 matchup with the ladies. Your Highland ladies will face off against the Triton Trojans on Monday night at 5 o'clock. The men trying to get there as well against the Trojans. They would play at 7. Either way, HMC will broadcast Championship Monday, the ladies Region 4 championship at 5, the men at 7. And I believe we'll be streaming the play-in game, Region 4 winner and Region 16 winner, the following Monday. Free ball, Ramin Hinton got it! Ramin gives the Cougars a lead with just over a minute to go. 25 points for the freshmen. Crowd has come alive along with the Cougar bench. Black to Mason, not the man I want shooting it, and it's airballed. The crowd is going wild here at the Larry Cole Gymnasium. 53 seconds left to go. The Cougars by 1 with the ball. Winner gets Triton, 7 o'clock Monday. Full court pressure now by the Cavaliers. D2 will get the ball. Just man-to-man pressure. Clear it on out. Demetrius will get it to Big Smooth. There'll be about 20 seconds left on the game clock if the Cougars run it down. Big Smooth going to drive with it. He'll hand off Ramin Hinton. Ramin going to take it down himself. Tries to save it off somebody. No good. 25 seconds left to go. Black will come down. Cavaliers have a chance for the lead. Placide, 3 ball, no long, 2. Cougars, that's a turnover. It hit the stanchion. Shot clock is off, and here come the fouls. 14 seconds left to go. Cougars up by 1, 61-60. Time to get the free throw shooters in the ball game here because the free throws are going to be a coming. Timeout taken, I believe, by Kankakee. It doesn't matter. Timeout taken by somebody. The Cougars, they are out of timeouts now with 14 seconds left to go in the ballgame. Highland battled back and now has the lead, 61-60. And we'll be back in a minute. The only place you can watch the end of this ballgame is right here on HMC. Nowhere else. Stick it with us, baby. Welcome back. There's no need to go to commercial because we don't have any anyways. But with 14 seconds left to go in the ball game, the Cougars have the ball all the way at the other court. And some, you bet your biscuits, there's going to be some fouls coming here. The Cougars have not shot well from the free throw line at all tonight. They're about 5 of 15, and that's unofficial, give or take. In for the Cougars now is Big Smooth, D2, Marquan Adams, Ramin Hinton, and Demarius Splunge. And is that going to be an intentional? It looks like it. Baldy called it. They're going to call it on him? You got to be kidding me. We're going to get a riot here as D2 picks up a foul. You've got to be kidding me. Who calls that? First foul on D2. You don't call that at this point. Terrible call. Tyler Johnson and Air Canada in. Splunge and Johnson, Demetrius Johnson will have a seat. 13 seconds left to go. Insanely bad officiating call there as they call a foul on the offense here. And I don't know how they do that because D2 was taking out the ball. Am I right on that one? Wasn't D2 taking the ball out? Okay. He takes every other ball out. I figured he was taking that one out too. Obviously a timeout. It's 14 seconds, not a minute 40, and not a 1.4. There we go. I believe Kankakee will take the timeout because Highland don't have any more left. 61-60. Now the Cavaliers will have the ball right underneath their own basket with a chance for the lead. Do you think they play for a shot to win it, or do they score quickly? If I'm the Cavaliers, I try to get any bucket any way I can and force the Cougars to be on the offensive end. I believe we got Big Smooth, Ramin Hinton. I can't see the bench there. Marquand Adams, Air Canada, and Tyler Johnson in for the Cougars. <clears throat> 14 seconds left to go in the ball game. Highland by one. A terrible offensive call on the other end. I expect a makeup call here. I'm sure I won't get it. Holmes to take the ball out. Cougars need to guard the inside of the bucket. Everyone's just looking for a layup. And they're going to call a timeout. Close to a 5-second call. Kankakee calls their second to last timeout. Still 14 seconds left to go in the ball game. 61-60 Highland. Cougar defense has to step up. No better place than right here. They lead by one, but they're defending the basket underneath. They're defending against Kankakee's basket right underneath there. 14 seconds left to go in the ballgame. 61-60 Highland. The only place you can watch this final basket here for the Cougars is right here on HMC. Don't go away. Crowd giving the Cougars a big hand. Still a terrible call. They haven't called a push-off all night, and they call one on D2 on the offensive end, which gives the Cavaliers the ball right underneath their own basket. Again, the Cougars have got to defend that open lane right underneath the hoop. An easy layup is what somebody's looking for. They get it to Stroud, 12 seconds down. I believe the Cavaliers are going to play for the win. Stroud's the man. He's scored in bunches. Shot down to 5. And they're going to call a foul, which is not a bad idea because they still have fouls to give. 4 seconds left. The Cavaliers are not going to the stripe yet. 4 seconds, only timeout left, and there it goes is Kankakee. 4 seconds left here in this ball game. Your Cougars still with a 61-60 lead. You want to watch the end of this ball game? No other place you can see it than right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. This is going to be a good one. Here we go, all timeouts are spent. It's this or nothing here. 4 seconds to go in the ball game. The Cougars with a 1-point lead. Winner gets Triton at 7 o'clock. I would assume it's gonna be a shot for Stroud or Black. And it's for the win. Tyler Johnson on the ball. They get it to Stroud. He's having trouble. Air Canada on him. No call. Cougars win. The Cougars will advance to Monday night. Big Smooth loves it. The crowd loves it. And we get away from the terrible officiating. Terrible officiating, but the Cougars prevail. That's what I'm talking about. Great job, Luke Norman and your Cougars. They advance with a huge victory, 61-60 over Kankakee. We'll be back here with some post-game interviews and some stats. Stick with us, everyone. It's only on HMC.
Another one busts the dust. Another one busts the dust. Ow! Another one busts the dust. Hey, hey. Another one busts the dust. Hey. Down the street, people way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the sound of the beat. Yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. And another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey. Hey, gonna get to do another one bites the dust. How do you think I'm gonna get along without you when you're gone? You took me for everything that I had and kicked me out of my own. I am a, I'm satisfied. How long can you stand the heat? I'm in the way the bullets can reach.
Welcome back, everyone. Cougars moved to 23 wins on the season with a huge win over Kankakee, 61-60. Cougars will be facing Triton in a double matchup. The ladies will play at 5 on Monday night. The men will play at 7:30. Nice job, coach. Nice work. Keep going. 2 to go.
Go!
Let's go, man.
Cougar bench just coming by here. Got to give him the high five. Scoring goes as follow. Marquand Adams, 3 points, 1 board. Big Smooth, Johnny Melvin with 10 points and 4 boards. Demetrius Johnson, D2, 3 points, 2 boards. Tyler Johnson, 3 points, 1 board. Gonzo Bastarachia, 3 points. Milos Kovacevic, 5 points and 5 boards. Cyrus Air Canada Noel, 2 points, 2 boards. Demarius Splunge, 7 points, 3 boards. My Cougar of the game, no question. Ramin Hinton, a big game last week. He has another big one tonight. 25 points, 11 rebounds for Ramin Hinton. My Cougar of the ball game. Stick with us, everyone. We'll be talking to head coach Luke Norman here in a few minutes after he gets done with his team. So stick with us. We'll be back in a minute. And remember, your Cougar men and ladies on Championship Monday will be this Monday at 5 o'clock and 7 o'clock. Stick with us, everyone.
Another one busts the dust. Another one busts the dust. Ow! Another one busts the dust. Hey, hey! Another one busts the dust. Hey! Down the street with the people way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the sound of the beat. Yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. And another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Yeah. Gonna get to do another one bites the dust.
Welcome back, everyone. Now the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Mr. Luke Norman. Luke, how's the heart beating after that one?
Oh, my God, man. I'm sweating. I'm out of breath. I felt like I just played for 40 minutes. But, man, what an effort by our guys today, man. Down 15 in the first half. Things not going our way. We held them to 20 points in the second half, man, and we just willed ourselves to victory.
Well, I was going to say, at one point, that was one of my points. He had 9 points surrendered in like 13 minutes of that second half, and I couldn't believe it. We were back. We were in the lead. Great job by the defense. First half, they shot 50%. Second half, only 25. How'd your defense do it?
I think we just kept battling, man. I mean, first half, they were making tough shot after tough shot, contested shots. Then second half, you know, I thought we played kind of the same defense we usually play. They just didn't make the shots, man. That's how the game goes. But give credit to Kankakee, man, and they played a great game. But, man, we found a way to win.
Good teams overcome adversity, and you guys did a great job with it. Free throws, the only thing I can see as a kind of a disappointment, only 38%. From the line. That didn't cost you, thank goodness. Is there anything that you do working on that, if it can get any better, or you just hope?
We shoot free throws every day, man. Okay. They just got to step up and make them. Sometimes it's not our night. And, you know, for us to battle through the adversity tonight, and even that last play, which I don't know how that was a foul on D2, but for us to get that stop there, my heart stopped for about 4 seconds when that ball went up.
It did too. Triton coming up on Monday. 7:30, you faced him several times, been close, especially here on the home court. What do you think of Triton again?
Triton's one of the best teams in the nation, man. They got scores, they got length, they got athleticism. So we'll get in here tomorrow evening, watch some film, get a little sweat in, and championship game Monday night in Freeport, man. And how about our crowd tonight? Great crowd tonight. Shout out Cougar Nation, man. They willed us to a victory.
Great job tonight. Good job, big win. We'll see you on Monday.
Yes, Monday. Shout out to our girls, our women's team, too, playing for a championship as well.
Exactly. We got the duplicate championship match of the Region 4. 5 o'clock, your Triton Trojans against your Highland ladies. And then at 7:30, your men will face also the Triton Trojans here. So either way, we were coming back, but it's a lot more fun now that we're going to have the Highland Cougars in both matchups. For the Salt and the Sound, Jim Yeager, this is the Marvelous One. Marvelous Mark Masters. We will see you on Monday night, 5 and 7:30. Good night, everybody.